Salvete omnes, nomen mihi est Caniculus. Thank you for joining me for this episode of the DDO code experiment. It is time to determine Venn's fate. So this is not going to be a happy time. And I know this probably makes things take a little bit longer, but I like to open up all of these gates. It lets me know at a glance whether or not I've checked one of these. Let's go this way. There's no strategy to this. Well, let me rephrase. I am not aware of an effective strategy. To my knowledge, Ben's body could just be in any of these. Let's take care of these guys. So I'm really doing this in kind of a haphazard way, so having these open really lets me know that I've checked a given area. Let's go this way. For no particular reason. Fear. Ugh. Go away, Sean. So if you talk to this guy, it spawns like a scorpion or something, but you don't have to. They probably should have had this chest locked until you did it. But they didn't, so you don't have to. One thing I don't remember is where the interrogator guy is. Not here. Golly, that's so good. I mean, that wasn't a one shot, because obviously hit three times, but it was a single push of a button. And that red name just died. Thank you. that's with very little range power. A bow that I'm happy with overall, but not anything super special. I appreciate the mushrooms, but I would rather find Venn. This isn't hard, it's just time consuming. Oh goodness, okay. Spring attack. Okay. I'm inclined to recast my spells, but used up quite a few of my spell points doing that. Oh, that brought me around in a circle. So let's go down this way and turn right. Get that in view so we know where it is in the map. And let's try turning right. Another mushroom. Found him? Yep, there we go. Alright, so now we need to find the interrogator, which I think we just did. There we go. Oh, nope, that's somebody else. Let's see. Now we don't have to look at the grates anymore, so let's just go up this way. And see what we find here. I don't remember how to get in that. We'll try this one down here.
Cruel implements of torture are scattered around this room.
I might take the guard killer bow? I don't know, we'll see. Alright, still just one. I need two for this. I might do conjure arrows, but at the same time, like, I'm not... Having a quiver that'll hold 1,500 of one type of arrow, I don't really feel pressure for arrows. I think I would rather have some additional damage first.
The strong smell of sewage permeates
Does
the air
this
around.
Say scales with melee power.
You hear human voices up ahead.
Guess that makes sense, but it would be kind of nice if it was melee power or electric power, whichever was higher. Because then any magnetism item I had would increase that and my electric arrows. Which I think I am going to go electric arrows. Seems to be a good theme for the character. That was cool. I mean, I know I'm like way over level for these guys, but that was cool. I just killed that whole grouping in one spring attack. That was awesome. I've never really used spring attack before, so. Get me the bow. And delete. Huh. Guard killer bow. Human Bane. It's a minimum level 2. It's not a bad... Detect secret doors. That's interesting. Fretting over this so much. I'm gonna hold on to this rune arm for later. Alright, a recall out. Okay, I got the Coin Lord's favor, so I don't need to focus on that. think I'll go do the catacombs. Do a run on normal. Some stuff sold off. I want to hold one of the potions of invisibility. I need that. Okay. Alright, with that, I will say gratias vobis ago. Thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe if you like what you see. And leave a helpful comment. I would love to hear from you. And I will see you next time for the catacombs on normal. Si valetis, ego valeo, valete.